Herbert mean?
It just means it doesn't have crust, which makes it great for all kinds of sandwiches like a BLT or turkey, tuna salad, any of them.
They all do look good.
Yeah, it's totally SFWL. Safe for work lunches.
Makes sense. I get it.
H-E-B Bear Bread, part of H-E-B's Primo Picks All-Star lineup.
You got a little something.
This is the original light beer. And 40 years later, we still brew it the same way. Because when you get something right, you don't mess with it. Miller Lite. Hold true.
Back live at Don Sanders Stadium here in Huntsville, you see the Bearcats and the Patriots. So far, the visitors taking care of business in this opening game of a three-game weekend series here in Huntsville. Dallas Baptist leading 6-0. Two runs in the first, three runs in the second, one run in the third. Bearcats trying to get something going offensively. Catcher Jordan Cannon lead it off for Sam Houston State. Cannon on the air hitting 265. Three doubles, three home runs, nine RBIs. He's a junior from Centerville, Texas, Centerville High School. First pitch from MD Johnson. A little low, ball one. Johnson's had a good start tonight. A couple of strikeouts that came in the second inning. Pitch called strike. You look at this Bearcat roster and talking to Matt Deggs today about recruiting. Up and down this roster, all Texas, there's one guy on the roster from New York, and the rest are Texas kids. The one player is Ben Hafner, senior from Lancaster, New York. So you got one New Yorker and all for the Lone Star State. I imagine they give him a hard time every now and then. Curveball, evens the count 2-2. MD Johnson wanted that one, didn't get it. Swung on, that'll get through into left field for the base hit. Jordan Cannon, first at bat, and the Bearcats have a runner off base. Here in the third inning, first hit of the game. Nice, smooth, compact swing there from Cannon. Just past Tim Miller, the third baseman for DBU, into left field. Bearcats looking to get something going here. Bottom of the order, the eighth hitter is going to be Blake Chisholm. Going on foul ball, so it's 0-1 on Chisholm. Chisholm hitting 280 on the year. Four doubles, two home runs, eight RBIs. This Bearcat lineup, and actually Bearcat roster in general, is six seniors, so this is a young baseball team for Matt Deggs. Well, that one got away from MD Johnson past the catcher, Matt Deuce. So Jordan Cannon will advance on that wild pitch. RBI situation now coming up for Blake Chisholm. One count on Chisholm. Here's the pitch. Swung on, foul off. So 1-2 now on Chisholm. MD Johnson again, good start tonight so far. Johnson pounds that strike zone. Seven walks, that's it this season, in over 30 innings. 1-2 pitch coming up on Chisholm. Oh, Bearcats really got the attention nationally last year with their postseason run and the job Matt Deggs has done with this program. Leader on and off the field. Swung on strike three, so Chisholm goes down. That's the third strikeout early in this game, and a big one there for MD Johnson. 6-0 lead, but get the runner in scoring position. Going to bring up the number 9 hitter, Chase Cryer. He's starting third baseman for Sam Houston State. Here's that last pitch to Chisholm. A little off balance there, and first out of the inning for Sam Houston State. Swung on by Cryer, fly ball right field. Runner will tag and advance. So Jordan Cannon advancing to third base with two outs now. Well, this Bearcat offense can strike quickly. So you're down 6 at home, it's something they're not used to in that position. But still early in this baseball game. Bearcats had the big tournament in Houston at Minute Maid Park. Jack Rogers now pinch hitting for Sam Houston State. For Riley McKnight. McKnight had grounded out in his first at bat and has struggled offensively. So Rogers now in there. He's the 6'2 freshman. He's from Klein Collins High School in Spring, Texas. Good area baseball, the north side of Houston. Houston area really highly regarded in general on the high school level. Recruiting hotbed for most college coaches. 1-1 pitch to Rogers. Swung on and missed, strike two. So two outs here in the third. One-two pitch from Johnson. Up and away, he was a count 2-2. Rogers hitting 176, just this will be his 18th at bat so far this season. Limited playing time, swung on and missed. That'll be strike three, and that'll do it in the third inning. So the Bearcats had a runner in position. Jordan Cannon advanced to third base. But two more strikeouts, four in the game now for MD Johnson. We are going to the fourth inning. So far, all Dallas Baptist, 6-0 over the Bearcats. Few changes for the Bearcats. Rogers, who just pinch hit for Riley McKnight, now the left fielder. Biles now in right field. And Hunter Hearn moves over to center field where McKnight had started tonight. So changes, you see that. Matt Deggs has a deep roster, not afraid to move guys around. We'll see that on most nights. Trying to get something going offensively here tonight. One hit through the first three innings. Trailing 6-0 as we start the fourth. Hayden Wesneski. Six runs and six hits so far tonight. Bandy with the bunt right back to Wesneski and over to Chisholm for out number one here in the fourth inning. Not exactly where Bandy wanted that one. Probably going for that third baseline, but again, well fielded there by Wesneski to get the out. Back to the leadoff hitter. This is Jameson Hanna. Had that three-run home run in the second inning. Ground ball out the first, so he's one for two with three RBIs. Swung on and missed. Great leadoff hitter for the Patriots. Entered tonight hitting .407. Also on a 20-game hitting streak, I should say. So he's extended that to 21 now with the home run. Her ball called strike. 1-2 now. Wesneski just looking for a clean inning here. No more damage. 1-2 pitch to Hanna. Swung on. Right field. That's going to drop for another hit. Second of the night for Hanna. Good speed. Nice hustle. Slides in safely. A one-out double for Jameson Hanna. Nice piece of hitting from Hanna so far tonight. Coach Hiefter, you love having a guy at the top of your lineup that can do that. And he's got speed and kind of gets things started. Nice swing right there for Hanna. Hanna's a junior from Flower Mound, so he's at second base now. Brings up the left fielder, Devlin Granberg. He struck out in his last at-bat, but had a single in the first inning, so he's one for two tonight. One out here in the fourth inning. Swung on, fouled off by Granberg. Looking around, the seats continue to fill up. And great support here. I've also seen some Dallas Baptist fans that have made the trip. That's only about 2.5 hours away. Easy trip to Huntsville. Up on the concourse before the game. So it looks like a lot of parents of some of the players have come up, made the trip south here to support their sons in the Patriots program. 0-2 pitch. Granberg thought about it, but held up. 1-2 now against Wesneski. On deck is Matt Deuce for Dallas Baptist. He had the two-run home run in the first inning to get things started for the Patriots. Dan Hiefner, the head coach of Dallas Baptist. 11th season leading this program. 399 career wins, looking for number 400 tonight. Big strikeout there, swinging by Wesneski. And Granberg goes down, second out here in the fourth inning. That'll bring up the catcher for Dallas Baptist, Matt Deuce. As you see the last pitch there, strikeout from Wesneski. Behind that one for the second out. Okay. 3 strikeouts on the night so far for Hayden Wesneski. But the Patriots have jumped on it for 6 runs and 7 hits here so far as we 2 out to the 4th inning. 0-1 pitch to Deuce, swung on. Fly ball right field, that's going to carry as well, but it'll hang up near the warning track and brought in by Biles there in right field, and that'll do it in the 4th inning. 6-0 Dallas Baptist leading the Bearcats as we head to the bottom of the 4th. Biles. Josh Biles at right field. Who?
Biles.
Is he? Josh Biles. Were those just the only two? Center and
no, we've got Jack
Harp. He's Harp's out. Jack Rogers. Back live at Don Sanders Stadium here in Huntsville as we head to the bottom of the 4th inning. A great night, a great start so far in this series by the Patriots of Dallas Baptist. Starting pitcher M.D. Johnson taking care of this Bearcat lineup so far through the first 3 innings. He's held Sam Houston Tate to just 1 hit. And that came from Jordan Cannon in the 3rd inning. So Trey Ochoa will start it off for Sam Houston State, second baseman. He had a ground ball out to third base in the first inning. And Bearcats looking for some kind of spark tonight. Coming in number 21 nationally. Dallas Baptist, not ranked, but an outstanding program. 11-8 start for the Patriots. First pitch from Johnson, right down the middle, called strike on Ochoa. Ochoa, new to the program, transferred in from Texas Tech. Shortstop Andrew Frigier on deck. Ground ball up the middle. That'll get through. Ochoa leads off the 4th inning with a single to center. Leadoff man is on for Sam Houston State against M.D. Johnson. Andrew Frigier now. He grounded out to shortstop in his first at-bat in the 1st inning. Frigier entered tonight hitting .322, making his 22nd start of the year. He started every game for the Bearcats.
I know, you have to get some shots. I'm just doing it for fun.
Swung on first pitch to Frigier. That'll carry out to left field. Devlin Granberg underneath that one for the first out here in the 4th. Josh Biles now, who entered the ball game. He's the right fielder for Sam Houston State. This will be his first at bat. Biles replacing Clayton Harp in this Bearcat lineup. Harp struck out in the 2nd. Not sure if it's injury related or just a expected change from Matt Deggs, but Harp out of the lineup now for the Bearcats. Biles at the plate, hitting 286 on the year. Delivery from M.D. Johnson, a little outside, ball one. Fifteenth at bat of the season for Biles, so not a lot of playing time. He started four games. Swung on and missed, evens the count 1-1. One out here in the fourth inning. I was looking to get something going here in the fourth inning. Against M.D. Johnson from Dallas Baptist. Johnson came in with an ERA of 5.06, but that's coming down quickly. Three shutout innings, just two hits allowed against this Bearcat offense. One pitch, swung on, base hit down the left field line. That'll be chased down. Held to a single, though. Grandberg gets to it quickly. We got a runner trap, though. Biles, they're going to get the out on Biles. He was trying to advance to second. But Trey Ochoa was standing there and could not advance to third, so a base running error by Biles. And the second out here in the fourth inning. Good Biles talking with Matt Deggs. Take a look at it again. There's Biles trying to advance to second, but Ochoa right there said, I'm not going anywhere. And a brief rundown and out number two. So third hit of the game for the Bearcats, but it backfires. With that out, so Hunter Hearn now at the plate. Swung on and missed. Hearn struck out in the second inning. He's hitting 346 on the year. Bearcats need him to come through here. 1-1 count now on Hunter Hearn. Swung on by Hearn to right field. That'll hang up there for Evan Sandman, and that'll do it in the fourth inning for the Bearcats. So they were threatening, but a base running error proves to be costly. We are through four innings here at Don Sanders Stadium in Huntsville. Dallas Baptist leading Sam Houston State 6-0. All right, we're back live here at Don Sanders Stadium here in Huntsville, Texas. Look at the upcoming schedule now for the Patriots. They enter tonight 11-8. They've yet to play a conference game. They've got the Bearcats again tomorrow and again on Sunday. They will visit TCU on March 27th and then host Southern and Xavier coming up next weekend. And you look at the history of Dallas Baptist, you got to figure they're going to start putting things together. They've shown they can do that. An annual regional team coming out of a tough conference. So far, so good here tonight. This series opener against the Bearcats, leading Sam Houston State 6-0. Hayden Wesneski still out there for the Bearcats. And a little bit of activity in the Bearcat bullpen, so this might be a key inning for Wesneski as he trails by 6. First pitch could be a pop up to center field. And Hunter Hearn right underneath that, out number 1 here in the 5th inning. Tim Millard now 0-for-2 tonight. And that's going to do it for Wesneski. Gets that first out here in the 5th inning. And his night is done. 6 runs, 7 hits allowed. Not the start he was looking for, but a pitching change here in Huntsville in the top of the 5th inning.
Across divisions, sports, championships, and schools, for nearly 500,000 student athletes, college sports create lifelong opportunity. And that starts with education. We've raised the academic bar, so more are earning degrees, creating healthier campuses by working with the nation's brightest minds, and making sure more have the chance to succeed and are supported on their journey. But beyond the numbers, it's about opportunity, and we're working to provide it for every student athlete.
What does it mean to be Southland Strong?
It's not just big wins.
It's success in the classroom.
And being engaged with service.
Family.
Passion.
Integrity.
Overcoming adversity.
Hard work and dedication.
Bettering people around you.
Striving for excellence.
Leadership and competition.
On our campuses.
And in our communities.
We are Southland Strong.
Dominic Robinson, the new pitcher for Sam Houston State. Sophomore from Tomball, Texas, 6'1", 200 pounds. As Hayden Wesneski's day is done. Robinson 1-0 on the season with an ERA of 7.04. He's pitched 7 2/3 innings, allowed 7 hits, 6 earned runs, and 7 walks along with 5 strikeouts. So be key to see what kind of control he has tonight against his Dallas Baptist lineup. Evan Sandman at the plate now for Dallas Baptist. Sandman walked in the second and had a base hit in the third inning, so he's 1-for-1 on the night. Patriots jumped on Hayden Wesneski early, 2 runs in the first, 3 in the second, 1 in the third. Swung on, foul ball. So Robinson trying to get a quality inning in here for Sam Houston State. A little outside. One of that one, so do the fans. Top of the 5th inning here at Don Sanders Stadium. Swung on, liner to center field, and that'll be tracked down nicely. Nice hustle there by Hunter Hearn to get out of the inning. For the out number 2 here of the inning. Well struck ball there by Sandman. Kind of tailing towards left center field, but Hunter Hearn right there to track it down. Brings up Cody Funderburk. Hitting six in his Patriot lineup. He walked in his first at-bat. Or had a ground out in his first at-bat, walked in his second at-bat in the third. We have foul ball down the right field line. Blake Chisholm got a hand, got a glove on it there. 1-2 count now on Funderburk. Dominic Robinson from Tomball, Texas on the mound now for Sam Houston State. Hayden Wesneski went 5 1/3 innings. 6 runs and 7 hits. A little inside on Funderburk, evens the count 2-2. Bearcats played a few days ago on Tuesday in Austin against the University of Texas. Funderburk line drive center or left field, that'll be a base hit. The 8th hit of the game for Dallas Baptist. Robinson kind of left it out there, and Funderburk went with it. That'll bring up Jimmy Glowenke. Here's the pitch again. Nice at bat there by Funderburk. 2 outs, and Funderburk on first base. Jimmy Glowenke, the shortstop, he is 1-for-2, had a base hit in the second, and lined out to right field in the third inning. Both these teams, last few years, have had plenty of guys coming off terrific seasons, get their name called in the baseball draft. One of the heroes for Sam Houston State, in fact, Robbie Rojas, the catcher from a year ago in the Milwaukee Brewers organization, ran into his parents on the concourse level before the game. They're on cloud nine. They're going to see Rojas out in Arizona at Brewers camp coming up this week. And he's advanced to the high A level already in a short period inside the Brewers organization. One pitch for Glowenke. Little low, 2-1 now. On the Patriots shortstop. Glowenke, a freshman from Louisville, Flower Mound Marcus High School in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. Well struck, but into the Bearcats bullpen there down the left field line. 2-2 count on Glowenke now. Runner on first base. Two pitch, blown outside, full count now on Glowenke. With Funderburk on first base after his 2-out single. Garrett Wolforth, the DH on deck for Dallas Baptist. 3-2 pitch, fouled off. Glowenke keeps the at-bat alive here. 6-0 Patriots lead over Sam Houston State. Great atmosphere here at Don Sanders Stadium. Again, one of the great venues in college baseball in the Lone Star State. Ground ball, third base. Chase Cryer over to first base, and Blake Chisholm for the final out here in the 5th inning. So Dominic Robinson comes in and gets the Bearcats out of this one, still trailing 6-0 as we head to the bottom of the 5th. Back alive here at Don Sanders Stadium, going to the bottom of the fifth inning. Upcoming schedule for Sam Houston State. They enter tonight 16-5. 6-0 already in the Southland Conference. Sweeps over Lamar and A&M Corpus Christi. Weekend series continues tomorrow and wraps up on Sunday here in Huntsville. Then a road trip to Arlington. They'll take on UT Arlington. And then next weekend, Abilene Christian as they continue Southland Conference play. And again, off to a 6-0 start. The defending champs from a year ago. Looking to keep it going in conference play. Tonight, looking to get something going against this Patriots team, who jumped out quickly with two runs in the first, three runs in the second, and one run in the third. 6-0 lead, bottom of the fifth inning now. Bearcats will start it off with Jackson Grisham, the designated hitter. He flew out to center field in his first at-bat in the second inning. Grisham coming into tonight, hitting 273, making his eighth start. One home run, seven RBIs on the season. MD Johnson, terrific outing thus far for the Patriots. Really kept the Bearcats offense off balance. Four shutout innings, just three hits allowed for MD Johnson. Called strike, now 1-2 on Grisham. Catcher Jordan Cannon on deck for Sam Houston State. He has one of the Bearcats' three hits tonight. 1-2 pitch. Out of way, evens the count 2-2. In this Bearcat lineup, very experienced. No deficit is too much to overcome. Although Johnson's done a nice job tonight, he continues to do so. As Grisham chases that one, and another strikeout on the night for MD Johnson. Five strikeouts so far. Let's take a look at it again. Nice delivery from Johnson. First out here in the fifth. Jordan Cannon, catcher at the plate for the Bearcats. First pitch fouled off. Strike one. Blake Chisholm, the first baseman's on deck for Sam Houston State. Patriots play Cannon straight away. Cannon hitting 265 on the year, making his 17th start of their 22 games. He's a guy that Matt Deggs likes to have in the lineup. MD Johnson, as we told you, big frame, 6'6", 185-pound junior. From Red Oak, Texas. Well, Cannon's going to get first base on that one. Tim Millard tried to get a hand on it and couldn't, so the Bearcats have a base runner here with one out in the fifth inning. Blake Chisholm now looking to keep things going here against MD Johnson. Here's the last play again. Laying down the bunt, Cannon. Miller tried to bare hand it. Never an easy play. You got to hustle on that play, and everything's got to go right. Didn't happen, so. Runner on first base now with Cannon with one out. Chase Cryer on deck for the Bearcats. Cryer, the ninth hitter, but he's hitting 371 on the year. Fourth hit of the game for Sam Houston State on that bunt single there by Jordan Cannon. Jackson Grisham led off with a strikeout. Cannon with the bunt single. Chisholm looking to keep this inning going in advance. Get the Bearcats on the board. One pitch, fouled off by Chisholm. 1-2 hole now, with one out against M.G. Johnson. Pitch from Johnson. Swung on and missed. Strikeout on Chisholm. And that is strikeout number 6 on the night for M.D. Johnson. That was big. Second out of the inning now. And it keeps Jordan Cannon at first base. Chase Cryer now, the third baseman for the Bearcats with 2 outs. As you see, Chisholm inside pitch. On the breaking ball from M.D. Johnson. Curveball called strike against Cryer. Cryer flew out to left field in the third inning. Another curveball called strike, so Cryer now in a hole against M.D. Johnson. Command of all his pitches tonight. O-2 pitch coming up from Johnson. Curveball, ground ball, third base. And they'll get the force out at second. Millard over to Bandy, and that'll do it in the fifth inning for Sam Houston State. We are through 5 here at Don Sanders Stadium. And it's 6-0 Dallas Baptist. Back live at Don Sanders Stadium, as we told you about the changes a couple of innings ago when they moved things around. You see the right fielder out there, Josh Biles. Hunter Hearn was out there, moved to center. And Jack Rogers now in left field as well. So some changes made by Matt Deggs over the last inning or so. Dominic Robinson back out there. He replaced Hayden Wesneski last inning, got out of a somewhat of a jam, not a big one, but made some progress as he hasn't pitched a lot this year, so it was a good confidence building inning for Dominic Robinson. We start the sixth inning here in Huntsville. This is Garrett Wolfert, the designated hitter. He popped up to the catcher in his first at bat and then grounded out to shortstop in the third. He's 0-2 tonight. Luke Bandy, the second baseman's on deck for Dallas Baptist. He'll be followed by the leadoff hitter, Jamison Hanna, who's had a monster night here in the series opener. A couple of hits, including a 3-run home run. 0-2 pitch from Robinson. Curveball outside. Well, swung on and missed. And Wolforth hustles down first base. No throw able to be made there by the catcher Jordan Cannon of Sam Houston State. So the strikeout, but the runner advances to first base here to start the sixth inning. First strikeout for Dominic Robinson. But again, base runner allowed as the pitch got away from him. Catcher Jordan Cannon. Luke Bandy now at the plate for Dallas Baptist. He has struck out, also popped up to the first baseman, so he's 0 for 2. Bandy entering the game hitting 188. And that average has now dropped to 167 from Bentonville, Arkansas. He's a sophomore for the Patriots. Swung on and missed. Evens the count 1-1. Bearcats down 6-0. 8 hits for the Patriots. And 4 hits for Sam Houston State. One count now on Bandy. No outs here in the top of the sixth inning. Two-one pitch from Robinson. Tried to bunt, popped up. Nice hustle there by Jordan Cannon. Got a glove on it. And the fans appreciate that effort. Nearly brought that one in. The foul ball by Bandy evens the count 2-2. 6-0 lead with Garrett Wolforth on base for Dallas Baptist. Bearcats number 21 in the nation, 16-5 record entering tonight. 2-2 pitch from Robinson. Fouled off again by Bandy, so good at bat, keeping things alive. Jamison Hand on deck. He'll be followed by Devlin Granberg of the Patriots. Again by Bandy. You talk about Dallas Baptist. They rank in the top 25 in 5 offensive categories. Number 13 in doubles per game. Number 13 in doubles overall with 48. Number 18 with home runs per game, nearly 2 a game. 23 on the season. This is a lineup that loves to swing the bat. A little hopper to Frigie at shortstop. They try to turn the double play, but Bandy beats the throw at first, so they get the force out at second, and that's the first out here in the sixth inning. So Bandy at first base with one out as the Patriots go back to the top of the order. Jamison Hanna, the junior from Flower Mound, Texas. Grounded out to shortstop in the first inning. Then a big 3-run blast in the second. Also doubled in the fourth, so he's 2 for 3 tonight. Dominic Robinson in his second inning of work for the Bearcats. Hayden Wesneski, 6 runs and 7 hits in his outing against his Dallas Baptist lineup. Yeah. 0-2 pitch. One and two now on Jameson Hanna. That one bounces in. Cannon tries to make the throw, not in time, as Bandy advances to second base on the wild pitch. So one out, runner in scoring position now. Good speed there by Bandy. Hustles down to second base, so runner in scoring position now for Jameson Hanna. And a 2-2 count here in the top of the sixth inning. Two-two pitch, called strike three. Big strikeout for Dominic Robinson. That's his second since he came in for Wesneski. That's a tough out to get, Jameson Hanna. Devlin Grantberg now at the, or Grantberg, I should say, at the plate for Dallas Baptist. Grantberg has struck out twice since his base hit in the first inning. He also scored a run as well. They're going to put Grantberg on and pitch to the catcher, Matt Deuce. Grantberg hustles down to first base. So runners on first and second now with two outs. Bearcats looking for the force out to try to get out of this inning, down 6-0. Matt Deuce now at the plate had the two-run home run in the first inning to get things started for the Patriots. And it flew out to center field in his second at bat. Dominic Robinson trying to get out of this situation here at the top of the sixth inning. Wild loose ball for Cannon, and both runners advance now, so the force out situation not at play anymore. Runners on second and third now for Dallas Baptist. Good heads up there by Bandy when the ball got away from Cannon. The two outs for Matt Deuce, trying to add to their 6-0 lead here in Huntsville. 1-0 pitch. And blocked by Cannon. Tim Miller, cleanup hitter on deck right now for Dallas Baptist. Cap. Well, Bandy almost got caught napping there, but Cannon gunned down. Bandy got back there in time. Dominic Robinson trying to get out of this little jam here in the sixth inning. 2-0 pitch, back to 3-0 pitch, and he'll take a walk to load the bases for the cleanup hitter. Tim Miller coming to plate. He grounded out to shortstop in the first, was hit by a pitch in the third, and it flew out to center field in the fifth inning. Now a chance to knock in a couple of runs here, if not more. Miller tied for the lead on this Dallas Baptist team in home runs. He's got 5 home runs and 19 RBIs on the year. Hitting .324 on the season. Time came out. Dominic Robinson's night is over. Another pitching change coming up for Sam Houston State. Here the sixth inning, 6-0 Dallas Baptist.
Growing the growl is not just a saying or an expression. I take it as more of a Bearcat way.
It's time for everybody to get together. So anybody comes out, the community of Huntsville comes out and just get together, wear your orange.
To me, Grow the Growl is more than just letters on a stadium or words on a pamphlet. It's more about an overall feeling of spirit.
You made the commitment to come to Sam Houston. Commit all the way, 100%.
Success does not come easy. Winning championships takes hard work on the field of play and in the classroom by our student athletes.
Thank you for blessing me with this opportunity and your support so that our future Bearcats can continue our winning tradition.
Play your part in building champions and become a Bearcat champion today.
Outs here, sixth inning. After the pitching change here for Sam Houston State. Riley Cooper in, left-hander for the Bearcats. Cleanup hitter, Millard. With the bases loaded. Called strike. Nice off-beat pitch there by Riley. One pitch, swung on and missed. 2-2 now with two outs. Cooper, 6.75 ERA. This is his fifth appearance of the season. Pitched just four innings. Looking to get out of a major jam here in the sixth inning. Down 6-0 to Dallas Baptist. Swung on, fouled off by Miller. Miller with 19 RBIs on the season. Devin Sandman on deck for Dallas Baptist. That's going to do it in the sixth inning. Take a look at this again on Millard. That'll be a strikeout, and Cooper comes in and does the job for Matt Deggs, and that'll end it in the top of the sixth inning. The base is loaded, still 6-0 Patriots. Back live at Don Sanders Stadium here in Huntsville, Texas. College baseball here on ESPN3. Randy McAvoy with you here. Been all Dallas Baptist. MD Johnson so far tonight against this Bearcat lineup.
Here you go, MD.
Bearcats held to just 4 hits so far in this one. Jack Rogers, the freshman from spring, the left fielder after a couple of changes early in the game. He struck out in his first at-bat tonight back in the third inning. He replaced when Roddy McKnight was moved around, they made a couple of changes in the outfield. Jack Rogers, one of those, along with Josh Biles. Rogers, 6'2", close to 200 pounds, played his college ball at Klein Collins High School. Klein ISD in spring, about 30 minutes south of Huntsville. Three and one count now as we begin the bottom of the sixth inning. Sharp ground ball up the middle. Well played there by Glowenke. Lost his footing there for a second, but fired over to Funderburk for the first out here in the bottom of the sixth inning. Good swing there by Jack Rogers. Right through the legs of MD Johnson. Glowenke, no problems there for the first out. They were shifted a little bit up the middle on that for Rogers. First out here in the sixth. Trey Ochoa at the plate now. Ochoa hitting 342. Takes a called strike, evens the count 1-1. He's 1-for-2 tonight. Starting second baseman from Rockwall, Texas. East side of Dallas area. As I mentioned earlier, transfer for the Texas Tech program here at Sam Houston State. 1-2 pitch from MD Johnson. Not sure of his pitch count so far tonight, but solid outing thus far for Johnson. Well, Choa tried to hold up, he didn't. Deuce fires down to first base, that's out number 2. 71 pitches so far for MD Johnson, so very efficient work tonight.
Shortstop number 7, Andrew.
Ochoa tried to check that swing, it didn't, and Bearcats still looking to get something going offensively. Andrew Frisier now at the plate. 7 strikeouts so far for MD Johnson, by the way. Frisier grounded out to shortstop in the first, flew out to left field in the fourth inning. He's 0-for-2. He's hitting 315 on the year. Yep. 2-1, fouled off by Frisier. No activity in the Patriots bullpen. Again, pitch count fairly low, but since it's a non-conference series, every coach has their own approach when they come to a weekend set. 3-game series in this case with the Bearcats. 2-2 pitch, a little outside. 3-2 now on Andrew Frisier. We talk about the control that MD Johnson has had all season long. No walks tonight. And that'll hold up right now. Frisier, well struck left field. Does it have enough? Yes, it does. Home run for Andrew Frisier. the season. 20th RBI, the Bearcats are on the scoreboard. Fifth hit of the night for Sam Houston State. Frigé, could that be the spark perhaps they're looking for? 6-1 now, Dallas Baptist. Josh Biles, the right fielder for the Bearcats, he entered the game back in the third inning. With two outs here at the bottom of the sixth. For Dallas Baptist, number 33, Travis Stone, working his way down to the bullpen. So we'll see the thought process of head coach Dan Heefner. Biles, good swing on that one, 2-1 now. Biles, a junior from Dulles High School in Sugar Land. Fort Bend ISD, that's the southwest part of the Houston area. Good baseball down there year in and year out. 2-2 pitch. Down low, 3-2 now. So again, no walks tonight allowed by MD Johnson. Thunderberg, and the Bearcats behind the solo home run from Andrew Frigé get on the scoreboard, but they still got work to do tonight. They trail 6-1 as we head to the seventh inning here in Huntsville. Andrew Frigé back at shortstop for the Bearcats. Hope solo home run. Get Sam Houston State on the board in the bottom of the sixth inning, but that's all they could manage. 6-1 lead now for Dallas Baptist as we hit the seventh inning here at Don Sanders Stadium. First game of a three-game weekend set here between the Bearcats and the Patriots. Riley Cooper back out there on the mound for Sam Houston State. Got that one out there that last inning to get the Bearcats out of the jam. Evan Sandman will lead it off here for Dallas Baptist. Quickly at an 0-2 hole. Sandman has walked. He singled to left, also lined out to center. So he's 1-for-2 tonight. Called third strike. So a quick strikeout from Riley Cooper. Came in with just four innings of work this year, but looking sharp tonight against Dallas Baptist. And Sandman goes down on strikes. Brings up Cody Funderburk, first baseman for Dallas Baptist. He's 1-for-3 tonight. Nice curveball there from Riley Cooper, the MVP of that regional in Lubbock a year ago. Had a lot of work in at postseason play. The go-to guy for Matt Dex. A little outside, 1-2 now on Thunderbird. Thunderbird, a junior from Arizona, swung on and missed. So two quick strikeouts from Riley Cooper. Two outs here, top of the seventh inning. Jimmy Glowinski, the shortstop for Dallas Baptist at the plate now. Two outs here in the seventh. He's 1-for-3, had a single in the second, lined out to right field, and ground ball to second base. So very quick work there from Riley Cooper here in the seventh inning. Three up, three down. We go to the bottom of the seventh now. Bearcats trailing 6-1 to Dallas Baptist. Back live here at Dot Sanders Stadium. Nice crowd, Bearcat Nation out supporting the Bearcats here tonight. And again, as I mentioned earlier, pretty good turnout too. I saw quite a few fans from Dallas-Fort Worth area supporting the Patriots program, but they draw well here at Dot Sanders Stadium. And when you win big, like they've been doing in recent years, especially under Coach Matt Deggs, popular event, especially on a nice night like we've got in Huntsville tonight. The result, not what they want yet. 6-1 lead for Dallas Baptist. M.D. Johnson, who started this game, 7 strikeouts tonight. He's allowed just 5 hits in that one run, the solo home run in the 6th inning to Andrew Frigier. That was it. Hunter Hearn will lead it off now for Sam Houston State. Began the night in right field and moved over to center field when Matt Deggs made a few adjustments. Hearn has struck out, also flew out to right field. When he leads off an inning, he's pretty good, hitting .474 on the year. .341 average overall. Swung on and missed, quickly 0-2 hole, or actually 1-1 now, I should say. No, it is 2-0, 0-2. M.D. Johnson, very sharp tonight. 88 pitches so far for the Patriots right-hander. 0-2. That's hits the top of the fence, I think, in left field, and that's a home run for Hunter Hearn. Left fielder for Dallas Baptist, Devlin Granberg chasing after it. And from this vantage point here, the press box, I think it hit the top of that fence and bounced over. Fifth home run of the year for Hunter Hearn and RBI number 22. Ball's really carrying well to left field tonight. Frigier with the home run, and now Hunter Hearn. Here's a look at it again. Good swing on it off M.D. Johnson. Yeah, it looks like it hit the top. It went over. Bearcats will take it. All of a sudden, 6-2 ball game now here in the seventh inning. Jackson Grisham at the plate, designated hitter for Sam Houston State. Hitting .257 on the year. He's flown out to center, also struck out in the fifth inning. He's looking for his first hit. Big gap up the middle defensively there for Dallas Baptist. Chopper, MD Johnson has to hurry. Throw down to first base and out number one. That ball just kind of hung up there, so Johnson really had to pick and fire quickly. He got the out as he fired down to Cody Funderburk at first base for Dallas Baptist. Still a little bit of activity down there in the Dallas Baptist bullpen. Pitch count now at 96 for MB Johnson. So you got to think that perhaps Dan Heifter trying to see if Johnson can get out of this inning and then hand it off to the bullpen for the final two innings. Jordan Cannon at the plate now for Sam Houston State. Blake Chisholm on deck. He'll be followed by Chase Cryer. They keep the inning alive. Single game, one game tonight, obviously. One game tomorrow in the afternoon. Series finale coming up on Sunday for both of these teams. Missed by Cannon, 1-2 now. Hitting 294 on the year. Cannon, a junior out of Centerville, Texas. Up and down this roster full of Texans when you look at the Bearcat roster. 1-2 pitch. A little bit low, evens the count 2-2. Matt Daggs telling me today, hey, we're near a hotbed of the Houston area. We're near a hotbed of Dallas-Fort Worth area. When it comes to recruiting, he says you don't have to go very far. There's too much talent. Full count now with Jordan Cannon. And that's going to be the first walk of the night for MD Johnson. Allowed only 7 so far on the year, so that's his 8th. But a great night so far tonight. Just over 100 pitches now, 102 pitch count. With one out here in the 7th. One runner on, one out here in the 7th. First baseman Blake Chisholm at the plate. Well, they'll talk it over here on the mound or perhaps make a change. They might make a change. He's over 100 pitches tonight. We'll see if they just want to see how he's feeling physically right now. Sixth and a third inning so far for Johnson. 8 strikeouts on the night. He's allowed these 2 home runs each of the last 2 innings. So mentioned the bullpen warming up. That's Jared Bayless, the junior out of Texarkana. They're going to stick with MD Johnson for now. Could be with the caveat of you got to get this out. If not, we might have to make a change with the pitch count being where it is. Chisholm hitting 269. Swung on. That's going to carry to left field. Is it enough? And it's gone. A home run for Blake Chisholm. A 2-run shot. Bearcats are back in this game. Well, as we mentioned earlier, no deficit is a big concern really for Sam Houston State with this offensive lineup. And they continue to chip away. They had one run in the sixth, three so far here in the seventh inning. Opposite field, two-run home run from Blake Chisholm. Dan Heaftner comes out. And it's going to make a pitching change. What a great night, though, from M.D. Johnson, who leads with one out here in the seventh inning. Four runs, seven hits, eight strikeouts on the night. A pitching change, Jared Bayless coming in for the Patriots here in Huntsville.
This is the original light beer. Brewed to be everything you want in a beer. And less. Miller Lite. Hold true.
Dude, what's up with your sandwich?
Oh, this is H-E-B Bear Bread. You know, the network, they heard bear and assumed that it meant naked.
So what does bear bread mean?
It just means it doesn't have crust, which makes it great for all kinds of sandwiches, like the BLT or turkey, tuna salad, any of them.
They all do look good.
Yeah, it's totally SFWL. Safe for work lunches.
Makes sense. I get it.
H-E-B Bear Bread, part of H-E-B's Primo Picks All-Star lineup.
You got a little something.
This is the original light beer. And 40 years later, we still brew it the same way. Because when you get something right, you don't mess with it. Miller Lite. Hold true.
Back live at Don Sanders Stadium here in Huntsville, Texas. 6-4 lead for Dallas Baptist, but some power coming back for the Bearcats. Hunter Hearn leading off the inning with the home run to get it started for Sam Houston State. And then Blake Chisholm has just hit a two-run blast. So all of a sudden, Bearcats with signs of life. They're back into this baseball game. And a pitching change. M.D. Johnson out. Jared Bayless in, the junior from Texarkana. 6'3". 225-pounder. Bayless with an 0.66 ERA. This is his 10th appearance in 13 and two-thirds innings. He's allowed eight hits and five runs. Only one earned run, though. He's walked seven, struck out 17. So he's in to take care of business for the Patriots here in the seventh inning. Chase Cryer trying to keep it alive here with one out. Bearcats with some movement down towards their bullpen. Cryer hitting 359 on the year. He's 0 for 2 tonight. Couple of ground outs. One-oh pitch, called strike, evens the count 1-1. So two of the top programs in the state of Texas going head-to-head here. Good tradition for both Dallas Baptist and Sam Houston State. Swung on, well struck, and that'll drop in left center field. Cryer with a stand-up double with one out here in the seventh inning. The bats silent most of the night, all of a sudden coming alive here in the last couple of innings. Jack Rogers at the plate now for Sam Houston State. Here's a look. Cryer, nice compact swing and drives that one to left center field. One hopper off the wall, easy double. And an RBI situation coming up for Rogers. Rogers, the freshman from Klein College, checked into the game in the third inning. Inserted into left field. First pitch for Jared Bayless, a little inside. One-oh pitch, called strike, evens the count 1-1. Rogers grounded out to shortstop at his last at-bat. Struck out in the third. 2-1 now at Rogers. Trey Ochoa on deck for the Bearcats, followed by Andrew Frigier. Frigier had that home run back in the sixth inning. 2-1 pitch. High and outside, 3-1 now on Jack Rogers. Ground ball, first base, great stop at first. Over to Rogers, they got the out at first base. Jack Rogers diving in, but what a stop there by Cody Funderburk in the hole, flipped it over. And Bayless there just in time to get his foot on the back. Second out here in the seventh inning. Take a look at it again, there's the flip. There's Bayless. Looked like he may have got a hand in there first. Nice hustle by Rogers. But the out is called, two outs now. Cryer advances to third base on the play. Ochoa, first pitch. Pop up to shortstop. Blow a key, and that'll do it in the seventh inning. So a tough break for the Bearcats, but they chip away with three runs in the seventh inning. We go to the eighth, St. Dallas Baptist leading 6-4. We head to the eighth inning here at Don Sanders Stadium in Huntsville. Bearcats down and out early, and actually most of this game through the first five innings. All of a sudden, last couple innings, one run in the sixth, three in the seventh. They're back in this now, 6-4 game. And Ryder Cooper back out there for the Bearcats. Very impressive so far out of the bullpen. Garrett Wolforth will lead off for Dallas Baptist. He's hitting 172. First pitch from Cooper. Out to Jack Rogers in left field. First out here in the eighth inning. So the theme tonight for Riley Cooper is very few pitches and very efficient. He's only thrown 15 pitches so far in his outing. Gets to work. Lots of movement on his pitches, and he's attacking his Dallas Baptist lineup. Positive way so far tonight. Blaine Jones now pinch hitting for Luke Bandy. Blaine Jones, the freshman from Munster, Texas. So Luke Bandy's night is done. He was 0-for-3 on the night with a strikeout. And 1-2 quickly, Riley Cooper on Jones. 22 on the year. This is only his 46th at bat. Strikeouts in his limited playing time. Leadoff hitter Jameson Hanna on deck for Dallas Baptist. Here in the eighth inning, two-run lead for the Patriots. First game of a three-game weekend series. 2-2 pitch, called strike three. Off-speed pitch from Riley Cooper. He's been living with that all night, keeping these Patriot hitters off balance. Another strikeout for Riley. That's now four strikeouts in his two innings of work. There's Jameson Hanna now, hitting .412 on the season. He's 2-for-4 tonight. One run, three RBIs. Had that big home run in the second inning that put the Patriots on top 5-0. 0-1 pitch, curveball there for a strike. Quickly 0-2, Riley Cooper against Jameson Hanna. Got a piece of that one to stay alive. The 1 o'clock game coming up on Saturday. 1 o'clock on Sunday as well as the series wraps up. Patriots will make the trip two and a half hours north, right up Interstate 45. This is an easy trip for them. Play down here in Huntsville. And fouled off by Hanna. Dallas Baptist has a game against TCU on the road coming up this week. UT Arlington road trip for Sam Houston State. And then they return to conference play next weekend against Abilene Christian. 1-2 pitch. A little outside, evens the count 2-2. And his home run earlier in the game, his third, but that's going to be his second strikeout and a fifth strikeout for Riley Cooper. What a job he's done out of this Bearcat bullpen tonight. We go to the bottom of the eighth. Bearcats trail by two. Back live at Don Sanders Stadium here in Huntsville, Texas, campus of Sam Houston State. Bearcats looking to keep chipping away at this deficit. They were down big early, but last couple innings they've gotten back into this thing. One run in the sixth, three runs in the seventh. And the heart of the order coming up here in the eighth inning, leadoff man Andrew Frisier. Hitting .322 on the season. Leading off an inning, he's hitting just .235. He'd like for that to change. Tonight, Frisier with that big home run in the sixth inning. First run of the night for Sam Houston State. Solid work at shortstop tonight. Frigé, the junior from Liberty, Texas, Liberty High School. Facing Jared Bayless, swing and a miss, first out here in the eighth inning. Josh Biles next up for Sam Houston State. He entered the game back in the third inning. Clayton Harp came out. Struck out in his last at bat in the sixth inning. In Biles, the junior from Dulles High School in Sugar Land, Missouri City, Texas. Fort Bend ISD. Annually produces some great baseball. 0-1 from Bayless, fouled off. Well, Biles now in an 0-2 hole. Bearcats had a 9-game winning streak snapped in the loss in Austin earlier this week, 3-2 loss to the Longhorns. They reel off that 9-game winning streak after losing their last two close ones at the Shriners Classic at Minute Maid Park in Houston. In that tournament, they beat Vanderbilt to open play. High and inside, nearly got a piece of Biles. 2-2 count now. Bearcats have a win over Baylor and Waco. 2-2 pitch, swung and a miss, another strikeout. From Jared Bayless. Two of them lead off this eighth inning, Frigé and Biles. And now it's Hunter Hearn's turn. Try to keep this inning alive. Hearn with the big home run in the seventh inning. One of two the Bearcats had, a part of that three-run frame in the seventh. First pitch, fastball, fouled off by Hearn. Hearn hitting 349. He's 1-for-3 tonight with that home run at RBI. Also struck out. That came in the second inning. Well, fastball also got a piece of the umpire, home plate umpire, lost his balance. Trainers are going to come out, make sure he's okay. That popped off his mask. And it looked like he just lost his balance when he was backpedaling. We'll make sure he's okay, though. The training staff's out there right now making sure he's in good shape. That was a fastball from Jared Bayless. Fouled off by Hearn. Looks like he's okay. A round of applause for the fans here at Don Sanders Stadium. That is not an easy job, folks. When you got a 90-mile-an-hour fastball or more at times coming at you, it'll get your attention quickly. Hearn, the junior out of Crosby, Texas, trying to stay alive here. 0-2 pitch from Bayless. Swung on, struck him out again. He strikes out the side, and the Bearcats go down to the bottom of the eighth inning. Impressive inning from Bayless. Dallas Baptist leading 6-4 as we head to the ninth. Take a look at that strikeout there from Jared Bayless. 1-2-3 as he mows down the Bearcats in the eighth inning. Strikeout to Frijay, Biles, and also Hunter Hearn. And a 6-2 lead, or 6-4 lead, I should say, for Dallas Baptist as we go to the ninth inning. Another change defensively for Sam Houston State. Mac Odom now inserted into center field. Also, Hunter Hearn moving back to right field where he started the game tonight. Few changes tonight for Matt Dex. Hoping for an offensive spark coming up in the bottom of the ninth inning. Riley Cooper back out there again. He's pitched 2 1/3 innings tonight. 0-2 on Granberg. Cooper had 4 total innings of work this year. And he's close to matching that tonight. O-2 swung on, line drive right field, right there for Hunter Hearn, out number one here in the ninth. Matt Deuce now, the catcher for the Patriots, hitting third in the Dallas Baptist lineup. 2-run home run in the first inning, got the Patriots on the board. Since then, he's flown out to center field and also walked. One for three on the night. Cooper trying to shut him down here in the ninth inning and give this Bearcat offense one last chance. Her ball inside. 2-1 count now on Deuce. Deuce hitting 192 on the year. Swung on, fouled that one off. Evens the count 2-2. Coming up for the Bearcats in the ninth inning, unless there's lineup changes for Matt Deggs. It'll be Jackson Grisham, Jordan Cannon, and Blake Chisholm at play for the Bearcats. Cleanup hitter on deck for DBU. 3-2 offering. Just a piece of it there by Deuce to stay alive with one out here in the ninth inning. A shift in place there for the Bearcats. That was a foul ball. That'll bounce over the railing there. Bearcats had shifted, so that shortstop and third base side was wide open for Deuce. And they'll keep the shift in place here. Seen a lot more of this across baseball, not only the big league level. Houston Astros, perfect example. The analytics involved. Bearcats implementing some of that as well. 3-2 offering. Chopper down the first baseline, foul ball. Strikeouts now for Riley Cooper. Out number two here in the ninth inning. Check that, make it 6 strikeouts now for Riley Cooper. 3 full innings of work so far after having just 4 on the season. Ground ball, third base. Chase Cryer can't handle that off his glove. Nice hustle by Miller to second base. Well struck ball there by Millard. Ricocheted off his glove. Not sure if it took a bat hop or if that's going to be an error on Millard, or on Cryer, I should say. Millard advances to second base. Two outs in the ninth. Runner in scoring position. Yeah, it looked like a bat hop there. We'll see if they give him a hit or not. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. I believe it might. They might have given him a hit. If so, ninth hit of the evening for Dallas Baptist. Yeah, they're going to credit Miller with a double on that play, as they should. That was a bad hop there at third base by Cryer. Evan Sandman at the plate for Dallas Baptist. Swung on and missed, off-speed pitch, evens the count 1-1. So 9 hits so far tonight. 8 hits for the Bearcats. Most have come since the 6th inning. M.D. Johnson did a great job against his Sam Houston lineup. Curveball a little bit outside. 2-1 now on Evan Sandman, the right fielder for Dallas Baptist, hitting 250. 1-for-4 tonight. Has a strikeout. Hitting 190 with 2 outs. Trying to change that. Called strike, evens the count 2-2. He is hitting 300, though, with runners in scoring position. He's got a chance to knock in Millard now with a base hit. Left center field gap wide open right now for Sandman. Instead, line drive to right field. Hunter Hearn right there for the last out. Well played. And that'll do it in the top of the ninth inning. Do the Bearcats have a comeback left in it? We'll go to the bottom of the ninth. They trail 6-4. Back live, bottom of the ninth inning here at Don Sanders Stadium in Huntsville. Bearcats of Sam Houston State trailing Dallas Baptist 6-4. Bearcats shut out in the first 5 innings. And then bounce back with runs in the 6th and 7th inning. Jared Bayless in there again for Dallas Baptist. Jacob Finke. Pinch hitting now, the junior. He will pinch hit for Jordan Cannon, the catcher. Jackson Grissom, the designated hitter. Finke hitting 250. First pitch, fly ball right field. Evan Sandman underneath that one. Out number one here, bottom of the ninth inning. Jordan Cannon with 1 out. Cannon's 2-for-2. Also with a walk tonight. He's hitting 294. Jared Bayless. Nice job out of the bullpen tonight for Dallas Baptist. count on Cannon. They got a piece of him there, so Cannon heads down to first base. Potential tying run now at the plate for Sam Houston State. Blake Chisholm, the first baseman. Here's a look at that last pitch. Right inside, right off that left arm. Cannon. Down to first base. Blake Chisholm. Last at bat, guess what he did? Home run left field. And now he's got another chance with one out here in the ninth inning.
Get out of here!
Fly ball left field, is it enough? Home run, Blake Chisholm. Two-run shot, ties this game at 6-0. Has stepped up and matched his season total of home runs with two tonight. The balls are carried out big time in left field. That's exactly what he was looking for. Bayless makes a mistake and we're tied 6-6. Chase Cryer at the plate now with one out here in the ninth inning. Cryer 1-for-3. He had a double. He's hitting 369. Swung on, fouled off, evens the count 1-1. Cryer had that double to left field back in the seventh inning, part of a three-run frame for Sam Houston State. Jack Rogers on deck for the Bearcats. Dan Heifner with the slow walk out to the mound. Let's keep an eye on that bullpen. Hard to tell from this vantage point. Looks like somebody's up in that bullpen for Dallas Baptist, and they will make a pitching change. So Jared Bayless had been rolling, but the Bearcats strike again. They were down 6-4. Blake Chisholm, the hero again. Back-to-back home runs for Chisholm. We're tied 6-6 with one out in the ninth inning. Pitching change for Dallas Baptist.
We believe the best light beer to have with friends is the original light beer. Always brewed with more taste, less calories, and half the carbs. Miller Lite. Hold true.
At HEB, we are all about Texas beef because we're dedicated to supporting local Texas ranchers, like Dr. Charles Graham from Gonzales, Texas.
I've always loved working ranch animals, so I became a veterinarian to ensure my cattle got the best care 24/7. They need lots of TLC, and I'll make sure to get it.
Ranchers like Dr. Graham are why HEB buys more Texas beef than anyone else. This is the best Texas beef department at HEB. No store does more than my HEB.
We believe the best light beer to have with friends is the original light beer. Always brewed with more taste, less calories, and half the carbs. Miller Lite. Hold true.
McGregor Hines, the new pitcher for Dallas Baptist, the sophomore out of College Station, Texas, 6 foot. 198 pounds. ERA of 4.15 on the year. He's 1-1, 13 innings pitch, 11 hits, 6 earned runs, 21 strikeouts in his 13 innings of work. And the old hair, Chase Cryer at the plate for Sam Houston State. And a 1-1 count All tied 6-6. If you're just tuning in, it was all Patriots. They built a 6-0 lead. They were cruising through the first five innings before the Bearcat bats came alive. One run in the sixth, three in the seventh. Two more here so far. Bottom of the ninth inning. Bearcats still with one out. They need to push one run across to get the victory. Chase Cryer and McGregor Hines. First pitch outside, 2-1 count. Ben Cryer, 1-for-3 on the night with a double, hitting 369. 2-1 pitch, swung on and missed. Got a piece of it, actually. 2-2 count now on Cryer. Getting into it, but many of the fans that came here tonight have stuck around for this one. Started back at 6:30, 2 hours and 45 minutes. What a finish here. Deuce fires down to first, out number two here in the ninth inning. So Hines comes in. He's a strikeout pitcher, and he got a big one there. Back to the top of the order for Sam Houston State, Jack Rogers. Rogers inserted in the third inning, hitting 150 on the season. He's 0-for-3 tonight. Ground ball, second base. Out number three here in the ninth inning. So we are going to extra innings here in Huntsville. Bearcats with two in the ninth to tie it 6-6 here at Don Sanders Stadium. Darian Sims has been inserted into the lineup now for Sam Houston State. He's in left field. Placing Jack Rogers. As we head to the 10th inning, extra innings to get things started in this three-game series between Dallas Baptist and Sam Houston State. Riley Cooper back out there. He's got 3 1/3 innings so far tonight. He's thrown 46 pitches. Cody Funderburk will lead it off for Dallas Baptist against Cooper. Funderburk hitting 258. He is 2-for-3 tonight. An RBI, also a walk, swung and missed there. 1-2 now. As a leadoff man, he's hitting 294. Jimmy Glowenke, the shortstop, on deck for DBU. Off speed, strike three. 7 strikeouts now for Riley Cooper. In just 3 2/3 innings. Glonke 1-for-4 tonight. Hitting 234. Ground ball out his last two at bats, the second and third base. His lone hit came in the second inning. 1-1 pitch. Ground ball off the glove of Cooper. Frigier fires over to Chisholm for the second out here in the 10th inning. Riley Cooper, story tonight for the Bearcats. 4 innings of work now at this point. He's allowed just 1 hit. That was a double, but he has struck out 7 Patriot hitters. Garrett Wolford now the designated hitter at the plate. He's 0-for-4. He's hitting 169. He struck out in the 6th inning. Flew out to center in his last at bat. Cooper very efficient tonight. 1-1 pitch. Off speed, a little high. 2-1 now on Wolford. Blaine Jones, who was inserted into the game for Luke Bandy at second base. He's on deck. With 2 outs here, 2-2 on Wolford. Get it. Base off ball for Wolford, so he heads down to first base. So runner on for Dallas Baptist. Blaine Jones now at the plate. He struck out in his first at bat. And the shift is on. Wide open on that right side. Ground ball, third base. Cryer, one hop, gets past Chisholm. Wolford advances to third base. Jones to second base with 2 outs. The inning is still alive for Dallas Baptist. For leadoff hitter Jameson Hanna. Hanna hitting 407. He's 2-for-5 tonight. 3-run home run in the second, double in the fourth. He struck out his last 2 at bats. Cooper. Lefty against lefty here. Devlin Granberg on deck for DBU. Patriots trying to punch one in here. Outside, 2-0 count now. With 2 outs, Hanna's hitting 440. Can he deliver now? Ground ball, first base. Misplayed by Chisholm. One score. Patriots have it up 7-6. There on Chisholm, he couldn't handle it. Good speed by Hanna. And Wolford comes in. Dallas Baptist back up 7-6.
Here you go, Devlin.
outs now for Grantburg. Blaine Jones on third. Jameson Hanna on first. We'll see if they send him or not. You got two outs, though. Shift is on for Grantburg, getting right side wide open. 0-1 pitch. Cannon with a nice block. But Hanna advances to second. Second and third, now two outs for Dallas Baptist. Pitch foul off left side. Get Riley Cooper coming in relief. Four innings of work, one hit. One walk, seven strikeouts, 63 pitches for Cooper so far. Grant Burke, fly ball right field. It's going to drop. It will. Now a 9-6 Dallas Baptist lead. Matt Deuce at the plate now for DBU with two outs. He's 1-for-4 tonight, hitting 189. He had that big home run early in the game. Got the offensive night going for the Patriots. At this point, Cooper just tried to get out of this mess, and Bearcats go back to work at the bottom of the 10th inning. Got to think with Dallas Baptist 11-8 coming in, this was a big series for them. Kind of a statement series against a nationally ranked team like Sam Houston State. Getting this first one of this three-game series. Key for the Patriots, tough stadium to win in. Bearcats always tough at home. Game two coming up tomorrow afternoon, finale on Sunday afternoon. 1-2 pitch. Who's just got a piece of it. Still 1-2. Seven strikeouts for Riley Cooper. He would love number 8 right here. Brandberg on first base, extending his lead. 1-2 pitch. Deuce hangs in there again to Chisholm. A couple of costly errors here by Sam Houston State. They were shut out after 5, started chipping away in the 6th inning with 1 run, 3 runs in the 7th, and then down 2 in the 9th. Chisholm with his second home run of the night, a 2-run shot, tied it, but the Patriots have answered here in the 10th. 1-2 pitch. Swung on by Deuce. And out number 3. Here in the 10th inning, but not before the Patriots push across 3 more runs. We go to the bottom of the 10th inning. Dallas Baptist leading Sam Houston State 9-6. McGregor Hines back in there for Dallas Baptist, looking to close it out here in the bottom of the 10th inning. Patriots responding with a three-run frame in the top of the 10th inning after the Bearcats had tied it in the bottom of the 9th inning. We'll find out if they've got another rally left in them here. Trey Ochoa will lead it off for Sam Houston State, hitting 333 on the year. He's 1-for-4 tonight, hitting 391 in a leadoff slot. Looking to get something started here in the 10th inning. Ochoa also with a strikeout tonight, transfer from Texas Tech into this Bearcat program. Yeah, tried to bunt, fouled that one off, so Ochoa now in an 0-2 hole. Millard was charging from third base, ready to field that if it came his way. O-2 pitch. Swung on, base hit up the middle, center field. Leadoff man is on, Trey Ochoa. It's going to bring up the shortstop, Andrew Frisier. Frisier with a home run tonight. He's 1-for-4 with a strikeout, hitting 319. He had the home run in the 6th inning, first run of the game for Sam Houston State. Some activity down to the Dallas Baptist bullpen. All quiet on the Sam Houston State side. McGregor Hines trying to finish it off here in the 10th. Count on Frisier. Fastball down the middle, called strike. Come back. 2-1 pitch, swung on and missed, evens the count 2-2. Ochoa on first base. Frisier at the plate. Ben Hafner on deck right now for Sam Houston State. Ready to pitch it. Ground ball. They'll get the out at first base. Hines got a glove on it. Misplay that just momentarily enough, though, where he couldn't get that force out at second base. So the easy option was firing over to Funderburk at first base. Runner advances, Ochoa to second, and one out now in the 10th inning. Good, Ben Hafner pitch hitting. He's out of Lancaster, New York. As we mentioned earlier, the only non-Texan on the Sam Houston State roster. Hunter Hearns on deck, so Hafner's pitch hitting for Josh Biles. Hafner's a senior. Ochoa on second base. Hines, first pitch, called strike. Always tough when you pitch hitting, you're coming off the bench. You've been sitting around for a while, although between innings, oftentimes you see the Bearcats doing quick sprints down to the left field corner just to stay loose. 0-1 pitch coming up from Hines. Curveball a little bit low, evens the count 1-1. Now in a 1-2 hole against McGregor Hines. With 10 hits tonight. Two errors, though, by the Bearcats. They were costly in that last inning. 1-2 coming up from Hines. Hafner fights that one off to stay alive. Ochoa hanging out at second base. Joe with the leadoff single to center field. And Hunter Hearns on deck. He's homer tonight as well. 1-2 pitch. Yeah, good at bat for Hafner. Staying alive here, keeping. Hines on edge a little bit. Fouled that one off to the right side. Hafner's had some success pinch hitting. Had a walk-off single in a Bearcat victory over Cincinnati this season. 1-2 pitch. Little check swing to first. Thunderbird flips it over to Hines for out number two. Ochoa advances to third base, so the Bearcats now down to their final out here in the 10th inning. Down 3-9-6. Hunter Hearn at the plate now. Hearn had a home run back in the 7th inning, struck out in the 8th. He's 1-for-4 tonight, hitting .345 on the year. McGregor Hines, first pitch. Outside, ball one. Hitting .387 with two outs. Called strike, evens the count 1-1. Hearn's got 5 home runs. That was his 5th earlier tonight. 22 RBIs on the season. One pitch. Bounces in there, but Deuce with a nice stop. Now on Hunter Hearn. McGregor Hines delivers. Swung on and missed. 2-2 count, two outs here in the 10th. Bearcats looking to keep this thing alive. Trey Ochoa on third base. Ball outside, full count now. Jacob Finke on deck for Sam Houston State. 3-2 pitch. Ground ball, third base. Millard over to first base, gets away from Thunderbird. Ochoa scores. Hunter Hearn advances to second base. Bearcats still alive. It's 9-7 now. First error of the night for Dallas Baptist. That'll be on Tim Millard. Dan Hafner coming back out for Dallas Baptist. We'll see if a pitching change is made or not. You got two outs. He's looking down at the bullpen. And he's going to call for a change here. We'll take a break here in the bottom of the 10th inning. 9-7. Dallas Baptist trying to hold on.
This is the original light beer. Brewed to be everything you want in a beer and less. Miller Lite. Hold true.
Dude, what's up with your sandwich?
Oh, this is H-E-B Bear Bread. You know, the network, they heard bear and assumed that it meant naked.
So what does Bear Bread mean?
It just means it doesn't have crust, which makes it great for all kinds of sandwiches, like the BLT or turkey, tuna salad, any of them.
They all do look good.
Yeah, it's totally SFWL. Safe for work lunches.
Makes sense. I get it.
H-E-B Bear Bread, part of H-E-B's Primo Picks All-Star lineup.
You got a little something.
This is the original light beer. And 40 years later, we still brew it the same way. Because when you get something right, you don't mess with it. Miller Lite. Hold true.
Jacob Finke, the designated hitter. Trying to keep this game alive for the Bearcats. First pitch from Towns. To Finke. Swung on, well struck, but right to left field. Devlin Granberg snares it for Dallas Baptist, and the Patriots hold on for the victory in the first game of this three-game series. Nice comeback, though, by Sam Houston State. They trailed 6-0. Runs in the sixth inning, 3 runs in the seventh, 2 in the ninth to tie it. But Dallas Baptist comes back with 3 runs in the top of the 10th inning. A couple of Bearcat errors, a factor in that. Bearcats with 1 here in the bottom of the 10th, but they fall short in game 1 of this 3-game series. Again, game 2 coming up tomorrow at 1 o'clock. And Sunday at 1 o'clock, the series finale as well here at Don Sanders Stadium. But game 1 goes to the Patriots from Dallas Baptist. Final score of 9-7. That'll do it for this broadcast from Don Sanders Stadium in Huntsville, Texas. I'm Randy McAvoy saying so long from Huntsville. Final score tonight, Dallas Baptist 9, Sam Houston State 7. To watch this entire game on replay, as well as other games on our family of ESPN networks, log on to watchespn.com or download the Watch ESPN app. This has been a presentation of ESPN.